Sway in the morning. Shade 4-5. Heather B, he came by here before. You got some of that town energy.
Why you always got to bring the town in it?
It's the only time I can. You know, it's good. I got family here. You know, man, he put this project out. He sent it to me. I started tuning into it.
That's a fact.
Really proud of him. Even always tell a story how my cousin Kwazi first introduced me to his music.
Mm-hmm.
And after he finally got me to listen to it, I was really impressed. I might even told Kwaz that, yo, man, that dude really made great songs.
Right.
Did I tell you that? Get on the mic. Kwazi's here, y'all. Get on the mic, Kwaz. What you doing, man?
Let's Kwazi, go. Step to the mic. Come on, can't have no dead air now, boy.
Come on, Kwaz. We live on air. Yeah, talk on the mic. He ain't used to it.
He 10 feet above the mic.
Look
what's good?
Nah, you remember that, though, right?
Yeah, we was at the house, at Graham's house.
Yeah, and I told him you make good songs. What else I say? You remember anything else?
Not just much.
That's Super Kid Cade's dad.
Right. Oh.
That's how people know him, and they don't know him from him.
That's
but,
my hero.
Thank you, Kwaz. That's it, man. You good. You off the hook, man. Yeah, you
hey, okay. Oakland niggas too cool.
You see oh, that, shit? Yeah.
You see he got a lean on the counter
the
like.
Always a lean.
Yeah, I remember that.
Man, what is that?
Forever a lean.
What you mean, what is it? You lean every time you but get
you
mad.
Lean you like lean it right now.
Oh, shit. Damn, word.
It's a lean. Look, I'm over here.
You are
it's
leaning.
Kinda, it's always
both
a slant.
Why the town lean like that? Why do we lean?
Too much flavor.
Oof. Wow. Too much to hold on one side.
Yeah, okay.
You got to bounce on this side. You got to do shit like that, Tracy G.
I see.
Your music palette is a lot broader than most people would imagine, especially coming from the town. You know, in the Bay, we got a sound. We got a signature sound we tend to stick to. Some people now have started gravitating even beyond those perimeters. What I say, expanding the sound, which I think you do. I think you're a student of the game. You study this shit, huh?
For sure.
Really?
For sure.
How? What's your research process?
It's really just stealing. I'm a good thief. I'm a good thief. I remember I was talking to the desk about this because she was like, you shouldn't use that word. But that's what it is. Like, I imitate the things that I love. It's just I'm a person that's able to absorb it and then release it in a way that's different than how I intook it. But either way, it comes from me stealing. Like, when I first wanted to rap, all my things were kind of pimpish and, like, overtly boisterous, just trying to be like Mac Dre the whole time.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Then I got into Dom Kennedy, and that's when I kind of smoothed it down.
Uh-huh.
I always been a character, so I take from Eminem and old school Ludacris and shit like that.
Uh-huh.
It's just me imitating the people that came before me, but I'm doing it in my own way.
You're a remixer.
That's Guap Dad 4000, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome him back. Let me say this. You remember when Nile Rodgers came in here?
Yes.
Nile Rodgers, one of the most famous producers from Chic.
In the world.
He works with Pharrell. Nile Rodgers, you don't know who that is, look him up.
Yeah, at this point.
The bass line from Good Times by Le Chic was taken, to your point, stolen by groups like Queen. So when you hear Another One Bites the Dust, when you hear the song Rapper's Delight by the Sugar Hill Gang.
Yeah.
Nile Rodgers came in here. And because I was asking them, how do you feel about people taking your creation and utilizing it to their benefit? He said, the most successful artists are the best thieves. You remember that? Y'all don't remember that?
Mm-hmm.
So I think what you're saying, some of the biggest names in music have really said the same thing.
Yeah.
That's interesting. So
where's Nile Rodgers from? From Oakland too? Y'all just
he
stealing
might be
out there?
It sound like he's from Oakland. All that game.
He might be.
All that game.
Just trying to connect.
All that game.
Y'all say.
My question is.
Wait, hold on 1 second. Mm-hmm. So, but at what point do all, after you aggregate all the stolen information, do you mix it in, and it's, now it's just uniquely yours?
I feel like one, it's practice.
Uh-huh.
It's after recording so much. And two, it's that's the magic in it. That's what people get attracted to, and it may be something that I can't explain because I can't take credit for what I do subconsciously, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, if I took something and decided to rap a different way, that's just how it came out. Luckily for me, it came out tight,
mm-hmm.
for the most part, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But, like, I feel like it's a certain level of magic to it, too. And uh-huh. that comes with individuality, you know?
Okay.
Now Roger's from New York, by the way.
He's from New York, damn, shit. Go figure. Yeah. All right, go ahead, Tracy. Sound like he from the town. You know.
Back to the hate.
Well, to still stay on this subject, is it a better compliment to be a strong, is it better to be a strong chameleon or to be unique but weak?
That's a good question. I think it's a certain amount of relativity to that, though, just depending on how you look at a chameleon,
mm-hmm.
because you could say a chameleon can be unique but weak in the way that he blends in. Mm-hmm. A chameleon his whole stick is not to be a standout.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like those could go one in the same. It's just kind of how you look at it.
And some people suck at being a chameleon.
A lot of people do.
Right. So that is actually a skill set.
Yeah.
right. I feel you.
A new album, Dior Deposits. You wrote every song on the album, right? Mm-hmm. You got, I don't know if there's another artist in the Bay other than 40 and Short. Like,
but shout out to the homegirl, Jazzy. She helped me on Gucci Pajamas.
Oh, Jazzy did?
Jazzy, yeah.
Jazzy.
Yeah.
Spell it.
J-O-Z-Z-Y.
Did you bring Jazzy up last time you were here? Did we talk about Jazzy?
I don't think I did.
No? Okay.
I met her in L.A., crazy enough, at a random black youngster session. And I went in there to just hear some records, and then me and black youngster went on an ego trip.
Mm-hmm.
And it got wild. Like, he had his own pair of Ethica draws, but he didn't know I had my own pair, and we both had them on.
Uh-huh.
So he was like flexing our waistbands, and he put his chains on. I started calling bitches up. It was
wow.
We didn't do no music.
Yeah, really? So y'all was just.
But I met Jazzy that night, and we've been friends ever since.
Well, what is that?
There's that.
Shit. What is that?
That's a different level of ego, though.
Yeah,
when the personality's just too big, you gotta go through it, though.
Yeah. So
like,
how
when
do you
got when you got two niggas who really come in peacocking, but like for the sake of being funny, not really for the sake of like I'm insecure. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It just
kind
of became like a just funny thing,
braggadocious.
And we just kicked it. Yeah.
I love black youngster.
Black youngster. That's the
He's
homie.
Tight. He's super tight.
Hilarious.
What did he say? You were recently. Everybody saw the punch that Russ threw at you.
Yeah.
Over a lyric. Yeah. And then so I had to really analyze it, because I'm a firm believer what you put in a universe, the universe shall reward you back.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing the punch, you felt like he cheap shot at you.
Mm-hmm.
Listening to the song, he felt like you cheap shot at him.
Yeah.
Right. Where do you go from here? Do you call it even? Because I saw the clip you invited him to fight one on one. Do y'all call it even?
But you know, I'm never gonna get that one on one.
Okay.
He's not a dude that'll do that. I feel like I'm, for one, I ain't calling shit even.
Okay.
Because when things escalate to a physical level and you go out of your way to plan to harm somebody, especially in my situation where I feel like I reached out beforehand.
What do you mean you reached out?
I DM'd the nigga like, hey, yo, I mentioned you in the song. Somebody came to me and felt like it was a diss to you, and I wanted to let you know that it's not.
Hmm. No shit. I didn't know that part of the story. Did he respond to it?
Nah, he seen it, though, as soon as I sent it. And the first time I meet this man, it was that. So, and you know, it, like, on some real, like, nigga shit, he caught me slipping. Mm-hmm. But I had no idea of any animosity that this man could have. And a lot of people was like, oh, man, it was so many. When you get surrounded by, but like, we rappers, bro, everybody got security. When I talk to my friends, it's 30 niggas behind them. You know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? So, like, yeah, couldn't nobody see that coming. I just got caught slipping, though. But are we even, no? Will I go out of my way to, like, pursue, to harm this nigga? No, because I'm a boss and I got bitches and, like, this is Russ.
Mm-hmm.
But, it's no forgiving. You can't disrespect somebody like that physically. You know what I'm saying? Like, uh-huh. he was headlining that show. I opened it. it make me, it's that's kind of like a flex that I could hurt the feelings of a headliner. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it is what it is. Mm-hmm. Like, I just got nominated for a Grammy.
What?
Yeah, for the Dreamville shit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit, damn. Quaz, you didn't tell me that. You did tell me. That. You did tell me. My yeah. bad, Quaz. I'm sorry.
You know what I'm saying?
So like, oh, my swag. What are you doing today, man?
I'm just happy they're here. That's all. I'm happy my little cousin in New York, all this town.
Yeah.
So,
So that's where I'm at with it. It's like, we from the town.
Yeah.
A lot of people who had real strong feelings about what happened on both sides, like, the people who was against me in the situation would have never been Guap Dat fans anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Just judging by like what they was doing and how, when I looked at their profiles, and most of the internet was on my side because like, bro, for one, I'm Guap Dat.
Yeah.
And two, like, I'm Guap Dat.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
What about three?
I'm also Guap Dat.
Okay, that's it. What you doing? With it? My bad.
So like, it is what it is. Yeah. People have never gotten punched in the face before.
Mm-hmm.
So I would never respect the opinion on a fight from somebody who never got punched in the face.
That's a fact.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
You feel the same way?
I keep telling you, sometimes people who haven't done what you done or even experienced, if you ain't make a record, what the fuck you commenting on my shit for?
Mm-hmm.
Shut the fuck up. Mm-hmm. You don't even know what we talking about. Mm-hmm. You don't even know how to get in the studio and do nothing. If you ain't never had a fight, been jumped, bossed up, owned a business, stop talking. Like, we not even talking to you. I understand that mentality. Yeah. I do. That's
but how do you keep business. This situation? Because I don't know if he knows how,
how it could get
being who you are from the town.
I mean, honestly,
how do you keep it from
personally, I done already took efforts to pull things back.
Yeah.
Because it's a lot of people, I don't want to say above me, but it's powers that be that are connected that I got a lot of love with that wasn't happy about the situation. And it's not like I'm some entry level dude. I am an entry level artist, but it's not like I'm an entry level nigga.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And it's unfortunate that he had to step over those boundaries for himself. Like I said, I would never go out of my way to like plan harm of somebody like how he did to me. If I probably see him, it'd be on site, but like I don't plan on seeing this nigga or going to look for that or nothing.
Mm-hmm.
I already told niggas, hey, let's not do that.
Good.
And that's where I'm at with it.
Good.
Your star's rising.
Yeah, bro. Yeah. I'm literally this probably what I will say is it was a learning experience for me, because I forgot that it was weak niggas in this world. I've been having such a meteoric rise, and I'm friends with everybody. You know what I'm saying? It's nobody that don't like, that dislike me, because I'm don't get nobody to dislike me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the nigga that you don't know that coming to the party. I've got bottles, I got bitches, I got jokes. Why would you even not? You know what I'm saying? And I kind of was getting lost in that sauce, and then that was just a reminder, like, hey, man, some niggas is just lame. Some niggas can't handle stuff. Uh-huh. And some niggas will go out their way to show you that they can't handle it.
Uh-huh.
And that is where I'm at with that. Other than that, I'm chilling.
You chilling? Guap Dat 4,000, man.
Go. You rising. Grammy nominated.
What?
Sway.
He what?
Grammy nominated, he said.
The Quaz, you told me that?
Let that go. Y'all too black. Just keep it moving.
Well, it's always when it happens. You know, it's like when your star is rising, that's when that dark, that negative is always trying to put you in a cross.
Distraction.
So the distraction. So you can't grow beyond the town and beyond the state and beyond the world. And then you can't control people's actions, but you can control how you respond to it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And so I just want to put that in your mind. Know that is something working against you. It utilized him. You know, he may feel like it utilized you because you put his name in that lyric.
He may have grown from it. He has a self-help book out right now.
Since that's he punched him?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's called It's All in Your Head. Get Out of Your Way.
Right.
Damn. Okay. What if he say, man, look, I might have the way I reacted was, you know, maybe that was uncalled for, extreme. It's the way I felt. But let's sit down, talk it out like men, and move forward. Would you be open to that?
Nuh-uh, I'll beat that nigga ass.
Come on. Really?
Mm-mm. It's, I just prefer to leave it alone because okay. It's a certain level of disrespect that I never cross. I don't care to heal from. It didn't hurt me. It was a speed bump, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I don't have a blemish on my ego or nothing like that. It's just like you was a person that wronged me to a point that I can never forgive.
Like, he should have did that beforehand, before it got to the fight and shit. Like, if he would have said, yo, let's just sit down and talk before it escalates.
Yeah, I mean, like, bro.
He sent the DM and he seen it.
Like, I don't care to, like, do the story time, but, like, like, yeah, nigga, cool. Like, you did what you did, and that's that. Mm-hmm. And you got to lay in the bed that you made. You decided to react like that, and it is what it is.
Okay. Guap Dad 4000. Dior Deposits, what songs have surprised you in terms of how people are reacting in different places?
Man, I got this song called Iced Out Gold Chains on the album. Mm-hmm. And speaking of Russ, this song was inspired by Raj.
Okay, Raj.
Yeah, Rex like Raj.
Rex like Raj, yeah.
Yeah, I was
wow, shit.
Well, you know, wait, hold on.
Yeah.
Listen to what he said. He brought up Russ again. I was going to move on. But Raj came by and said this about the whole situation, because apparently he knew. This is what he said.
I hollered at him before the incident, and we had discussed it. And you know what I'm saying? He made it seem like he wasn't going to do what he did. He made it seem like he was just going to holler at bruh.
Mm-hmm.
So when that shit went down, I didn't respect it. You know what I'm saying?
You didn't respect it?
Nah. But at the same time, you feel me? It's like, as a man, it's hard for you to put me in the middle of that situation just because I know both these people. These is two grown-ass men, and they going to handle situations how they want to handle it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have handled it that way. And then also on the other side, as a man, if you say something, you can't judge what another man's response is going to be to that.
Mm-hmm. Which is interesting, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't disagree.
Yeah.
And I fuck with Raj. I got a lot of love for Raj. I have nothing to say about that.
Okay. Iced Out Gold Chain was inspired by...
Yeah, just as... I like the way... I mean, because Raj follows suit with the melodies, kind of like how Sue was doing a lot mm-hmm. of... And then I was just thinking, channeling that energy, and I was making a beat in my car, and FL Studio crashed.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, fuck, I know that's tight. So I recorded it on my phone, and I had a session with this dude, Dupree, who produced the song, and we put them vocals over it,
mm-hmm.
and it's been sitting on a computer for like 2 years. A lot of songs on the album are like 2-3 years old.
Yeah.
And it was just always been a personal favorite of mine. I didn't know if my manager liked it. I didn't know who else liked it, but I just knew that I wanted that on the album, and that's... I get so many tweets about this song, so many people listening to it, people like to drive to it.
Uh-huh.
And it's tight that people say they like to drive to it, because that's what I was like. You know how we like to smash and shit.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I used to like to do 90 to them whenever I could drive. I don't really drive no more.
Well, you got a driver?
No, I just be around people that drive.
Okay. You got bitches.
You got Grammys. You got Grammy nominations. No. I'm going to play the song,
I'm
man.
I'm just not touching the wheel.
Okay, I feel you. Tory Lanez, Black, Chance the Rapper, G-Eazy, Buddy, Denzel Curry, Mozzie, E-40. They're all on, Neff DeFerrell, they're all on this album. Buddy, I said Buddy. They're all on this album. Dior Deposits, Guap Dad 4000. You know you family.
Yes.
All right. Yeah. I appreciate your conversation.
No problem.
You be safe. Every time. Be safe out there. Okay. All right. And get at me anytime you need me.
Yeah, you already know.
Okay. Slow. All right. And or get at Quasi and he'll tell me.